All right, so let's put some of these rules into play by actually doing some inference by hand. Ultimately, we're going to derive some algorithms that can do this, so you don't have to think about it so hard. But understanding those algorithms, it's helpful to have gone through an exercise where we actually use these ideas. So here's a setup. Let's imagine that we've got two boxes. One has four balls in it, and one has five balls in it. And we're going to choose one of those boxes uniformly at random, either the box that we choose is equal to box 1 or the box that we choose is equal to box 2. And after that, we're going to draw at random, uniformly at random, from what's inside the box, one of the balls. And let's say it turns out to be green. All right, so the first draw that we make, we have a green ball. We reach into that same box a second time, and the question is, what's the probability that that second ball will be blue, given that the first one we drew was green? So let's to help point out how this is connected with Bayes' net inference. Charles, why don't you help me draw the Bayes' net that corresponds to this problem?
Okay, so if I think about it as a process, which now means I'm thinking about this as things causing the other, the first thing that you did in the process is you picked the box.
Good. All right, so let's say, so the first variable in the net is going to be the box variable.
Right, and then once I had the box variable there, I can now pick. The second thing in the process is I pick a ball. So in this case, you're calling it 1. So I make the first pick.
And do we need an arrow there?
Yeah, because you pick the box, and then that lets you pick which ball that you have. So which ball you pick, the color of the ball you pick, depends upon the box, so to speak.
Good. And so the probabilities here are going to be, it's going to look like this. All right, so the second variable here is what color ball you get when you do the first draw from the box. And we can represent this as a conditional probability table. So for box 1, it's 3/4 green, 1/4 yellow or orange, 0 blue. And for box 2, it's 2/5, 0, 3/5. And so that captures what happens on the first draw.
So for the second draw, well, clearly that sort of depends upon what you drew the first time, because you said we were drawing without replacement. So it definitely depends upon what you drew the first time, but also it still depends upon the box. Okay, so now we've got tables for a box, we've got tables for ball 1, and we need to know what ball 2 is going to be. Well, the value that ball 2 takes definitely depends upon whatever value ball 1 takes.
Sure.
But it also depends upon which box you're in. So you need an arrow from there as well. And what would be really nice is if we were in the storm, lightning, and thunder case, where if I knew that it was what ball 1 was, I would know what ball 2 was. But that's not true, because in a case, for example, when ball 1 is green, it doesn't tell me what ball 2 is unless I also know which box I'm in. So we have to draw the arrow from box to ball 2.
Indeed. Right. And so there's a lot of probabilities that we have to write down. But let's just write down a piece of that table. Let's say that the value of ball 2 depends on which box, and it depends on what ball 1 is, but let's just look at the piece of that table where ball 1 is green, because that's what we're ultimately going to need here. So now ball 2, in the case where we're drawing from box 1, the probability that's green, in the case where the first ball had been green, it leaves just 2 out of 3, right? And 1 out of 3 yellow and no blue. But on the other hand, had we drawn from box 2 first, and again, had we had gotten green, now it's green 1/4, 0 yellow, and blue 3/4.
Right.
And we need the same thing for the other case where ball 1 is yellow and ball 1 is blue, but we're not going to need those numbers for this problem.
Right.
All right, so now that we've written it as a Bayes' net, is that helpful at all? So we haven't asked the question yet, so maybe it's time to ask the question, and then we can work on the answer.
Okay.
All right. The question is, what's the probability that the second draw is blue, given that the first draw had been green?